I'm Erika. I'm the Curator of Mineralogy here at the museum, and I'm going to be talking about a Canadian woman that minerals are named after. And then we have this photo of She-Ra because she's the defender of Crystal Castle, so it feels rather apt. But we start with Dr. Gabrielle Donnet. She was a German-Canadian professor over at McGill in Montreal, and she had Gay Donnet named after her, and she's well known for solving the crystal structure of tourmaline, which is a really big deal. She also had Donnetite named after her, as well as her husband, Dr. Joseph Donnet, who was a professor of mineralogy at Johns Hopkins University. So they're both very well known around the mineral world. And next is Anne Sabina, and she was an X-ray diffraction specialist over at the Geological Survey of Canada. And she worked there for a long time discovering new mineral species, and she's known for writing 17 books about rocks and minerals, so rocks and minerals for the collector. And I love how hopeful she looks in this photo. And then there's Elsa Horvath. Horvathite from Mont-Saint-Hilaire was named after her and her husband, and they're both keen mineral collectors that collaborate with us at the museum on minerals from Mont-Saint-Hilaire. There's a book coming out with some of our staff. There is Dr. Elena Sokolova. She is a Russian-Canadian professor of mineralogy at the University of Manitoba, and she works on complex titanium silicates on their crystal structure and chemistry. And we have Cynthia Pete. She was also an X-ray diffraction specialist. She was over at the Royal Ontario Museum, and she worked there for 23 years, and she had... she was a radar mechanic during the war, so I thought that was pretty cool. And then we're done. We are out of Canadian women that minerals are named after, which is a little odd because there's probably more than 100, probably in 2018, named after Canadian men. So why is there that reason? So there's about over 5,000 minerals around the world, and only about 90-ish are named after women. Most of these were historical, so named after scientists' wives. Now rules are a bit more stringent. Things are named after localities, chemistry, and people who have an impact on mineralogy. We can see here past couple years of new mineral names, and in yellow are women. So it's not looking good even now. There was even one named after bird excrement, so seems like it's a low bar for other things. And we see this problem in some of the other sciences. This is top 10 new species names. So it's a little biased towards kind of attention-grabbing things, but there's only two women. One was the patron saint of a city, and the other one was someone's daughter. The rest are either men or women or things like Gryffindori or something. We see it in paleontology and botany. I know there's a paleontologist, Dr. Phil Curry, who has like 10 dinosaurs named after him. So it can be nice if we got some women in there too. And it's not like men are sitting around going, we're not gonna name things after women. It's because historically, a lot of times, there weren't women in these sciences because if we look at the earth sciences, you know, even in 2006, only 16% were women. Things are getting better now over the years. And you know, what is that reason? As women get into more senior positions, especially in academia, there's something called the leaky pipeline. They start dropping out after the Bachelor of Science, PhDs, associate professors. And part of this is historically, there's less women. Women were pushed to be not allowed being allowed in the fields. They weren't allowed to be in the lab. They were only allowed to do you know, office work. They were pushed into botany or household science instead of geology because it was too rugged for them. But we still see some of these problems now. When people are surveyed as to why women aren't in the geosciences, men say it's the pipeline, it's just going to get better over time, or women just don't like geoscience. Women say there's structural issues, you know, bad family care, not great issues with their grad supervisors, and then you get told things like this. You know, I've been told at a women in science event that girls are bad at math, and that's why they don't go into science. And this was only a few months ago. So this is what you deal with from when you're a child, growing into trying to go into sciences. And hopefully we want to make this better. It is getting a little bit better if we see this graph. You know, becoming a geologist does have a little to do with the economy. So see a little dip to the mining sector there. But in purple is the Bachelor of Science, and it is getting better over time. And what can we do as a society? Having more women in senior positions so that they can mentor other women and they're better role models. Men tend to mentor other men. And also having good family policies for both men and women, because that does affect our careers. And hopefully in the future, we're gonna see some minerals named after some of my women colleagues, maybe some petliraganite or some presleyite. That'd be something really cool to see in the future.